Hey guys, Carlo here. Welcome to the vlog. Today we're going to do two things. First up, we're going to unbox and do an on-feet review of the new Jordan 1 Pine Green, I think. I don't know if that's the right name, but it's the green high Jordan 1s that just dropped recently. I actually picked this up over at Titan, and I was so pleasantly surprised to just see it sitting there because I thought I would have to pay resale for it. But fortunately, I paid retail for it. Very happy to be able to, you know, have this on the vlog, unbox it, and do a review for you. Now, after the unboxing and the review, I'll actually bring you guys along with me because we're going to head on over to my first ever chiropractor session. So, I don't know why I'm doing this. It's all for the vlog. So I'm going to drop by a chiropractor, talk to them about how it works, what it does, maybe get my first adjustment. I really don't know. But yeah, I'll bring you guys along with me. So if that interests you, stick around, watch the entire video. If you haven't yet, please make sure that you subscribe to the channel. We are about to draw the winner for the Nike React Infinity in your size. So make sure that you hit the subscribe button, follow me on Instagram, join our Facebook community, and then click the link in the description box for the rest of the mechanics. Good luck. So let's jump right into it. So as you can see, it comes in your typical Jordan 1 black red box. It says over here at the side, Jordan 1 Retro High OG Pine Green, size 13. I usually go a full size up on my Jordan 1s because I have wide feet and I want it to be a little bit loose. So if you pop the box open, you have the typical tissue paper and then you have the actual sneaker. Now, the laces usually come in black. I did wear it with red to be able to do the vlog. So those are the black laces over there. So this is what the sneaker looks like. So the upper is dominantly made out of black pebble leather. And green leather over here. So if you compare the quality of the leather, for example, to another Jordan 1, the leather on this one is a little bit more supple and softer. I think that should help with the creasing. Of course, this is one of my favorite Jordan 1s, which is the not for resale Jordan 1 in black and in red. Now, if there's one thing I'm not really feeling about the shoe, it's the Air Jordan logo here along the collar because it's raised. So it kind of pops a little bit versus your more sunken in like Air Jordan logo that you see over here. So I'm not a fan of how they implemented the Air Jordan logo on this particular sneaker. But apart from that, it's your typical Jordan 1. You have the midsole, color green outsole. You have the tongue over here with the Nike Air logo. You have the pebble leather for the toe box, which is resistant to creasing, which is what a lot of people don't like. So I actually wore this heavily for a day, and I thought that the creases would be much worse than we have right here. Now this is what it looks like with the red laces. Now what I'll do is I'll cut right now to an on-feet segment where I am wearing this in all red laces. So as you guys can see, the red laces make it pop, makes it a little bit more hype, makes it a little bit more noticeable. But if you want to make it more casual, what you can do is you can swap it out for the black laces, and that's what the footage that you guys will see next of me wearing it on feet with just the black laces. And the black or actual laces on the sneaker actually make it look far more cleaner and much more easier to wear. The red and green motif, I don't know if it gives Gucci vibes or Christmas vibes, but it really depends on how you want to wear it. Personally, I really prefer wearing it with the black laces, mainly because it just looks more classic and more subtle and fresh. Now, one way of doing it is if you want to really grab attention is you can wear one sneaker with red laces and the other sneaker with black laces, which I'll show footage of somewhere here as well. So you guys can get a comparison to how the three different ways on how you can wear this particular Jordan 1 sneaker. So again, I'll flash all three videos or all three on feet again. So this one is me in red, all red laces. This one is in all black laces. And this one is red and black laces. Which of the three ways you guys prefer? Let me know down below in the comment section. So do I recommend the Jordan 1 Pine Green? Well, if you love the Jordan 1 and if you love color green, and you are looking for a sneaker that can be versatile because of the laces, then obviously you can go out and buy one. Especially if you can still get it for retail, as long as you can get it for retail actually. The good thing is some sizes are still sitting in different Titan branches. So you just have to probably call them in advance and find out if your size is there before you go on over to their shop and try to pick one up. I was just really lucky. I didn't know that they had it. I just dropped by and peeked in the store to see what was there. And there was one more in my size that was just, you know, sleeping on the shelf. So I ended up buying it. Is it worth paying resale for? Maybe if it's just just a little, you know, a couple of thousand pesos more, or maybe 1 to 2,000 pesos more. But if you'll end up like forking out, I don't know, like 5,000 pesos more for it, that would be something I wouldn't recommend. In fact, the story, the cool story behind all of this is prior to me heading over to Titan, 2 to 3 people actually PM'd me on Instagram offering me their size 12 to 13 pairs. One guy was offering it to me for 12,000, another guy was offering it to me for 15,000, and one ridiculous guy was offering it to me for 18,000. I really don't know what to make out of that. But anyway, so it's just funny that all I had to do was actually go to Titan and pick one up for retail. And with that said, that wraps up our unboxing and on-feet review of the Jordan 1 Pine Green. So at this part of the vlog, I'll bring you guys along with me as promised as we have our first ever chiropractic session. Oof, let's go. Now, as we're headed down to the car, I want to show you guys something really annoying that we have to deal with every day here in the condo. So just outside of where I live, this is our neighbor, and you hear that annoying sound. Apparently they don't live here anymore, and either they sold it or whatever, and there's something that got triggered inside, probably the intercom alarm, and that annoying sound has been blaring for the last, I don't know, week and a half. So unit owner of 12A, if you are watching this, parang awa mo na, umuwi ka, ayusin mo to, dahil sobrang nakaka-istorbo. So the name of the place is the UN Chiropractor Clinic with Dr. Fisher. So we'll check it out and see how it goes. It's the first time I'm ever going to have like a chiro session, so hopefully it works out well. And I'm here with Dr. Fisher. Ta-da! So what we'll do now is we'll talk to him a little bit about chiropractic.
Yep.
The practice, and then maybe you can get to learn more about it, because I'm sure a lot of you have questions, a lot of you don't know what it's really all about, and this is like one of the best times to be able to learn about it. So Doc, maybe you can give us like a quick intro to what this is all about.
Sure. Well, my name is Dr. Chris Fisher, like what you said. I am a chiropractic physician, and basically what that means is that I deal a lot with the spine, but really any joint in the body. The spine, though, specifically, if it rotates or has a problem there, then usually it'll cause pinching on the nerves, and if it pinches on the nerves, then it's going to cause symptoms. So really basically what chiropractic is relieving that pinching on the nerves so that the body can be pain-free and take care of itself.
Okay, so remember I had you bending from side to side, and what I was finding was a spot right up in here.
Yep.
And down here. So we're going to get that one adjusted on you right now, okay? So you've seen some videos and things of people getting adjusted. I'm going to be super gentle, and it's not going to hurt, okay? So we're going to get this one right over here. You're going to get just a little bit of a pop. Really relax. There we go. Good. All right. Now let's get another one right over here.
That was fun.
So I get that reaction quite a bit. It's sort of like that initial, like, what was that?
Yeah.
And then it's like, wow, it feels so good.
Actually,
one,
it does.
One more right in here. And relax.
Oh, whoa, whoa.
Good. Yeah. So again, what that's doing is adjusting those individual joints. The popping that you're hearing is actually a gas that's being released from the disc there. So it's not a bone that's popping, it is the gas.
It's the gas. Okay.
As the gas releases from that joint, then that's the pop that you feel. Okay, just relax.
Whoa.
Not gonna hurt. Let this relax.
Hey guys, so I'm back here in the condo. Now I actually shot a segment where I talked about the feeling of the chiropractor session right after in the studio or outside their clinic. But unfortunately, the mic was off. So so I have to shoot this part again. So how was the overall feeling? Well, I went there with two main issues, or three. I had some pain when I would turn my head left, right, more to the left. So he did some adjustments to be able to fix that, and wow, there was really some sort of relief right after it, and I'm excited to continue taking up the sessions to see where it goes. And apart from that, I have a full ACL tear on my left knee, so most of the weight sometimes would go to the right knee, and it actually showed. So he did some adjustments on that as well. And lastly, on my shoulders, because I'm always doing like this when I'm texting and working on my laptop, he did some adjustments as well on my shoulder. and gave me some exercises to do as well for, you know, strengthening posture. So overall, the experience, pretty good. I would definitely come back. It's something that I found super nice. Great experience overall. And if you want to try chiropractic or chiropractor, check them out. I'll put the link down below. Oh, and one last thing before we close this vlog. So I wore this with the red laces the whole day. The red on green is kind of growing on me. Gucci vibes. But anyway, so that said, I'll rewind a bit, go back to the time I was in the clinic talking to Dr. Fisher, and we'll close it there.
Guys, that's it for my first chiropractic
session.
Again, I'm here with Dr. Fisher. The great thing is, if you want to learn more, he actually has a YouTube account. So maybe you can quickly, you know, invite them to subscribe to your YouTube.
Sure. On YouTube, I'm at Doc Chris Fisher, as D-O-C Chris, C-H-R-I-S, and Fisher, F-I-S-H-E-R.
Okay, guys, so if you want to have, you know, like a session, like an assessment, check them out. I'll put the link down below to where you can find them. But they're really just literally, you know, on the intersection of Timog as well as the other road,
Quezon Avenue,
in the Anita building, right?
Yes.
First floor.
The Delta Overpass.
And in terms of the cost, I did a quick check over there. I think it's like $3,500 for the first session, right? Mm-hmm. Which already includes the initial adjustment, right?
Yep.
And succeeding sessions are like 3,000 pesos each, which isn't bad considering how much you will save in terms of like surgery. If you get your, you know, alignment and posture and everything else fixed. So guys, that's it for now. Peace. God bless. What's up?
And
boom.